Hello students, in today's class we are going to see about XML tree structure and what are the tree, and also we will see an example of the XML code and how it is being implemented through the tree. So let's start with the definition of XML tree. So an XML document is always descriptive and the tree structure is often referred to as XML tree. So we already know that in hierarchical data, like this is an example of this tree, and it plays an important role to describe any XML document very easily. So before this we were using simply just like HTML and XML, but now hum log kya karenge, we are going to use XML tree, and in this tree structure the datas which are stored are being depicted in a very easy manner and a very user friendly manner, so that the hierarchy and the data of the database that are being stored in the XML is being reflected very easily. So the tree structure contains root. So similarly, jaise hum log hamesha tree padhte aaye hain, so we are also having here a root. This is the root one, and all these are the child of that root, child elements and so on. So by using tree structure you can get to know all succeeding branches and sub branches starting from the root. So from root se start karte hue we are having all the sub roots or the sub branches and till the leaf element, that is the child element. So the parsing starts at the root, then moves down the first branch to an element and takes the first branch from there and so on to the leaf node. So how is our this root is been done, ye root kaise use hota, execute hota, so that these are the branches of first one, and let's suppose this is only one branch of the second one, and here also I am having two branches. To ab iska jo flow hota hai, the flow of the tree will be starting from the root one, this will be the first, this will be the second, and after this second this will not be the third, the third one will be the left of this one, that is 3 4. Once the left will complete, it will move to the right one, after that 5 6, then now this one 7 and 8. So this is the flow of the tree, and the movement of the structure is being followed by left to right movement. After this, let's have an example XML mein how we write tree, how we write the codes, and it is being reflected in the form of tree. Kaise hota hai? So first let's start with the XML version. We have to write the version of the XML. After that I am having a company, so I can see over here that this company is the root element or the topmost topmost tag. So what I will do, I will mark here a company, and this will be my root element or the root. After that I am having an employee, which I know that this employee is also a sub root element. That means company ke andar pe ek dusra element hai, that is the employee. So I will mark over here employee. This is my employee. After employee I can see that I am having 1 2 3 4 and this 5. Inside the employee I am having 5 different types of tag, that is 5 child. So let's suppose as first one is f name, first name. After that this is last name. The third one is contact number. After that email ID, email, and at the last we are having address. So this is address. Now what we can see that in the address I am having more 3 sub elements. Address ke andar pe 3 aur sub elements hai. So what we will do that we will start this address tag, aur iske andar pe ye 3 city, this is the city, state and the zip, that is a pin code. तो दिस इज़ द स्ट्रक्चर हाउ वी फॉर, ये स्ट्रक्चर होता है कि जो XML का कोड होता है, एंड हाउ वी कन्वर्ट दैट कोड और व्हाट इज़ द आउटपुट ऑफ दैट कोड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ XML ट्री. So this is the example. Let's move on to the next one. So yes, here we can see that I am having a company, that is the root one, and that root contains a child, that is employee, and this child contains five child, that is first name, last name, contact, email and address. And among these five, this is the one that is the address. The address kya hota hai? Address may be my first teen sub child, that is city, state and zip. So in the above diagram there is a root element named as company, and inside that there is one more element, that is employee. Inside the employee element there are five branches named first name, last name, contact number, email and address. But inside the address there are three sub branches named city, state and zip. This I have already explained you, so there is no problem in understanding that how we can convert the XML code into the tree, XML tree. So let's start with the next topic, that is DOM, that is document object model. This is also a part of XML, and the DOM is the foundation of XML, and XML documents have a hierarchy of informational units called nodes. So in the last slide we have seen that the address, city, first name, last name, all those were the nodes. Wo kya tha? Wo nodes tha. Everything where the data is being stored in the hierarchical form is known as node. And DOM is a way of describing those nodes and the relationship between them. So let's suppose this is my one node and this is my two node. And what the DOM does, that DOM is a way of describing those nodes and the relationship between them. That means among these two nodes, what is the relationship that is being established over here? We can also represent it as the form of this diamond shape, or simply we can write over here. So a DOM document is a collection of nodes or piece of information organized in a hierarchy. And this hierarchy allows a developer to navigate through the tree looking for specific information. So whenever a developer wants to take some information or wants to get some information from the hierarchical tree, what it does, it starts the DOM, that is a document object model ko use karta, and it goes from one node to another. Aur ye one node to another ka iska jo traversal hota, that is always dependent upon the needs and the hierarchy of the tree. So this hierarchy allows a developer to navigate through the tree looking for specific information, and because it is based on a hierarchy of information, the DOM is said to be a tree based. So this DOM is also known as tree based parsing or tree based hierarchical structure. So the XML DOM on the other hand also provides an API that allows the developer to add, edit, move or remove nodes. So with the help of this DOM, what we can do, we can add a node, we can edit a node, we can move a node and we can remove a node. So all these are done in the tree at any point in order to create an application. So for creating an application, the XML DOM does, what does the XML DOM do? It add, edits, move or delete. Ye kya karta hai? Add karta hai, edit karta hai, move and it also removes the node which are there for the hierarchical structure. So these were the functions and features of DOM, and that's all for this video, and we are going to cover XML namespaces and XML database in the next video. Thank you.